What would you guys be cooking today?
Good, right?
Hey, bro, that food good?
Yeah, it's good.
Febreze, how you feel about Dooney?
Dooney grits, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you, dog. I ain't gonna lie.
A minute and 45 seconds.
I got you, bro.
Come on, man.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Mushroom risotto recipe. I taught my 4-year-old kids, so it's child-proof. They should be very easy, and they can handle it.
What's going on, everybody? My name's Sebastian Hemmerling, food and beverage manager here. Right now, what we are in the search for is 2 really good experienced cooks. So what we've came up with is with our chef, Chef Udo, which you'll meet in a little bit, is we decided to do a cook-off. So we have 3 teams so far, and what we're doing is we're gonna hire the best duo that we can find.
Oh, good, bro. You feel me? We both got the same competitive spirit. We don't like losing. We're driving, focused.
My teammate, he's pretty strong, man. I'm glad you put us together, man. He won't stop till he get that dub. That's why I'm glad we're together.
Now that we're heading into season, we really need 2 experienced cooks to hop into our team. So we are getting with Chef Udo, and we're gonna get a team going to cook some risotto, and the best team that wins will get employment here. That's what we're looking for.
Welcome to the first ever, as Sebastian already said, cook-off for a spot at the team. And what we're cooking today is a simple thing. I took it out of my kids' cookbook I made for them when they were 4 years old.
Do you guys have any past cooking experience, anything at all?
I mean, I'm not very good at culinary, but I feel like with today, with Udo, with Sebastian, you know, we got to get this thing done today. You know, we cook a risotto. I'm excited. How you feeling though?
I'm hungry.
You eat your breakfast, kid?
No.
Just gonna follow the rules. Might take some shortcuts, but only because, you know, we know what shortcuts to take.
All that book, y'all know the drill. Don't like, don't comment, and most importantly,
don't
subscribe to my channel.
No.
Let's get it.
I show you how to make the risotto, then it's your turn. My name is Udo Müller. I'm the executive chef here. I started my career in 1977, way before you guys were all born. So that's, 54 years I'm cooking now. Still enjoying it. And then at the very end, we're gonna taste it, or I'm gonna taste it, and we're gonna find out who won. As you can see, everybody has a lid in front and the cutting board.
Can you open it?
This man.
Oh, team one has a plastic knife. That means you're screwed.
You're screwed.
Plastic knife?
I think so.
I can't get a rubber knife?
You may open up your ingredients now from the napkin, keep your recipe, read it so you know what you're doing later. And what do you see? Everybody has chopped onions, but...
Yeah, whole onion over here.
Oh, okay, start chopping it.
Okay. Oh. Oh.
I'm gonna start crying, fam.
Not that.
For a 5-point deduction from your overall, I can give you 1 knife if you like.
You gonna take it or what?
I mean, who needs the most of? Who needs the rest? Y'all boys rich. Y'all need the rest.
No way.
What do you mean? You need a chopping onion.
You
need
a boy.
Be careful, no running. Underneath your grill, you find another tool you need to use. Underneath your, only you. Yeah, underneath, yeah. We don't want you to cut yourself. All right, so now everybody, while they're chopping the onions, gonna start watching me, what I'm doing here. So easy, my 4-year-old daughter makes it. We start with a little oil in the pot, right? Add the onions.
Do you have the temperature on full blast or?
Excellent question.
Yeah.
Yes, because this is not your household oven. As I said in the cooking class, it takes a little bit longer here to cook, so it's on full speed.
I'm not trying to lose.
No, I'm not trying to lose. All right, and
Do you want to take two ovens out?
How do you feel about your teammate Fabrice?
Feel good about him, you know? Thing is, one thing about him though, he does get mad fast. Kind of got similarities when it comes to that because I do get mad fast too. So that can disrupt our performance, but I feel like we can tame it a little bit depending on how focused we are on this assignment that we have. Yeah, that's pretty much it, bro.
Do me grits, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you, dog. I ain't gonna lie, bro.
You got it, Johnny? Yeah. Johnny, slow down, bro. You just on a waiver
scheme. That said, you can get your ovens ready.
I don't think our ovens work.
Whoa, it worked. Look how I do it.
Whoa, hold up. It's still over there.
How we have people saying they know how to cut, and they don't know how to open a stove?
So how do you feel about your teammate today?
I'm very confident in my teammate.
He got experience. I have a little experience. The other boys have no experience, so.
You know, he's a good listener. He pays attention. He follow the rules.
When you put two people in one, great minds, you know.
Let me see what happened there.
Looks like slice
out. Yo, but wash your hands. Wash your hands.
I've been washing. Keep chopping.
I'm not sure. Every 2 minutes. See what I'm doing? I'm chopping this shit, bro. A little chop. I'm getting there, you feel me?
Watch your fingers.
Ah, shit. Fuck with your boy.
All right, everybody has the ovens out. Underneath your table, there's a cartridge for you. Put that one in.
Oh, is that really?
We was never worried about it, man. We was never worried, bro.
That butane fuel.
Yeah, this that gas. You see how they just vibing right now, bro? They're not the window. They think they slit. They think they're the quiet assassins and shit. Like, no, they're not the window. What the hell?
We got in the bag, dog. I'm not just saying it for the cameras. I'm saying it because I feel like we really do got in the bag. I mean, shit, I never could result it before, but I feel like with our skill set and what we know, we're going to secure the victory. You feel me?
Whoa!
Don't make this shit, bro.
I feel like we're behind right now, bro. This shit dirty as hell. Rusty as shit.
I feel like we're gonna win. I feel like we're gonna win the whole thing.
Do you have any weaknesses between in your team?
Any weakness, I could say that I don't really cook like that. I can only cook eggs, but I can't, you know what I'm saying?
He lost, bro.
Oh, while those onions are cooking right now, I'm gonna add the mushrooms. And I hope you guys pay attention because later I said, oh my gosh, what did I do and why? So now, the next step where I put some stock in there.
Usually there's a plate under this.
I have my chicken stock.
I stored it on cilantro, whatever it's called. Curry.
Why?
Was it chicken? Yes. Curly parsley, whatever it's called. I put it chicken.
I got you. Oh,
yeah. My eyes, bro.
Damn. So you still want to work in the kitchen?
I want to work in the kitchen, bro. But damn, these.
Check me out. Check me out,
bro.
And you add a little bit of stock at a time. You don't want to put it all in.
They gave us a broken one, bro. There's no way, bro.
Stop complaining. This shit broken, bro.
It's not working? Well, for 10 points, I give you a new one.
Be careful. Is it
room enough? And sometimes you need a little bit more.
You're a cool guy. Yeah, I fuck with you. So, you're a very great man, dog. Your personality, the way you carry yourself is very cool. I appreciate that.
You're baiting me into something.
No, I genuinely mean that, though.
Oh, okay. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
You need help turning on the burner?
Yes.
Gotcha. Should have paid attention. I'll mark that down.
No!
I didn't even need it on.
Hey, yo,
we have a very low heat here, so it just kind of simmers along. If you do this at home, your boils away.
You mind this one?
I know.
Come on, you mind this one? What have you been like that?
Watch out. Maybe okay, it's 2.5.
Damn.
That boy's nice.
We switched our onions, bro.
A boil the rice. It's time to.
Hey, chef, we got a cheater.
All right, everybody has their pots on. Gets a little bit warm. Put it on low, low heat.
Try it. Put the oil on, too.
So now we're going to add the butter. It makes it a nice creaminess.
Right.
I'm gonna put my Ricardo in here. And I'm ready to go. Any more questions about the risotto? Because now it's too late. We're gonna start the competition.
Who do you think is gonna win today?
Excellent question. I have a favorite and I have a loser in my head right now, but I don't wanna say names. It's gonna be a nice, fun competition, and there's some obstacles also involved while we start and the competition. And it's gonna be fun.
Ladies and gentlemen, on your spoons. Off you go.
Where's Donald, fam? I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. I gotta talk to Tennessee some more. If I don't talk to them properly, there's gonna be some crunchy ass risotto, fam.
This is good, ain't it?
Well, I'm not seeing Fabrizio focused.
Oh, thank God, we got these, man. Well, you gotta start cooking.
Just that they weren't chopped properly, that's why.
So far, I see one guy working and the other one is.
No, we had to take turns.
Good, right? What's up, man? What's doing over here, man? Hello?
Don't like, don't comment.
And what's up, Donald?
Don't subscribe.
Man, subscribe, man. Don't subscribe.
They didn't find out yet. Yeah, I think I did own curly first. They didn't know yet.
You know me? We the underdogs. We always gonna come through, man.
What's going over there?
Spare. Oh!
Dude, come on, man. It's not that hot, bro. Come on.
He was blowing that spoon for a minute.
Bro, like, he was...
Bro, because as a kid, I got burnt so bad.
That's why you're making fried rice?
You gotta do it like salt bay.
Here. You gotta be like salt bay, you feel me?
Everybody using Haitian spice over there?
You said what?
Haitian spice.
Haitian spice.
1 minute and 45 seconds.
What? What's
going
on over there?
What's he talking about?
Who you think is gonna lose?
Everybody.
Dooney racks, CL Breeze first place. Jordan and Robinson second place.
Jordan and Robinson last place. I see it, bro.
We already won, I'm gonna be real with y'all. We said, we already won. I don't know why we here, but we already won.
All right, team one, please. He still got his gloves on.
Hey. Just quick feedback I had through. Being honest with you, wasn't the cleanest station I saw. And the last comment I had, the risotto was not cooked all the way, but let's see how the final product came out.
I'm gonna take that mushroom.
You don't eat the mushroom.
Well,
eat the tomato.
As Sebastian said, we had the extra hurdles in there with the onion, which is fine. You added the tomatoes and you folded them in so they get a bit warm. That was nice. Could have been a winner if you would have cooked the risotto a bit longer.
Damn.
When I saw you putting the butter and the cheese in already, and it looked like you're only halfway there, and I said, oh my gosh, that's a little bit too early, and then it was too early. Team two.
This is nice.
All right.
Chef, what I have is they added tomatoes, so they got points for that, but they got that point deducted for forgetting the parsley. Besides that, everything else looks good. Dish presentation looks good. They're clean station.
They stole our parsley.
Yeah. It's still shit,
man. Don't worry, it's on the film.
Oh, yeah.
Very nice executed, except two things.
What?
One.
Just let the man talk.
One was when I came over and then I saw the mushrooms going in after the white wine, they need to be sauteed. So otherwise, it's a really, really nice dish and you use the tomatoes.
Yeah. I think the consistency is really, really good. It tastes really, really good. I think when it comes down to dishes like this, we have to get very nitpicky about all the process because that's what the recipe calls for. As far as taste-wise, I do really enjoy
nice.
It.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So good job, boys.
Taste is very good.
First place, sir.
Thank you.
First place.
Team three.
And then Jordan and Robinson use the outside source to put their dish.
They used what? All right, team three, come on.
So this team is Robinson, Jordan, Chef. I took some notes on them during their presentation. I'd say that they were probably the most focused group throughout. Good presentation, their quality looks good. A little bit heavy on the parsley, but I think we'll be okay. Let's give it a taste.
Taste is very good. You paid attention while I was cooking in the front. I saw you guys, you looked at the recipes. You followed the recipe. You did exactly the dish I did. You didn't use any extra ingredients.
They did, actually.
What did they use?
Anybody using Haitian spice over there?
So what?
Haitian spice.
What Haitian spice?
Yeah, this that gas.
What? Are you serious?
Yes. Oh. Is that a disqualification?
Whoa.
Outside source. Whoa. Because if you're gonna hire someone that's bringing outside ingredients to the kitchen,
ooh.
You real supposed to know what this is right here.
I didn't see what happened.
Just gonna follow the rules. Might take some shortcuts, but only because, you know, we know what shortcuts to take.
Why would you hire somebody like that, bro? We want.
Now I'm a bit confused because I did not see what happened, and
yeah,
there's
you
a
didn't see it, but
and then
it,
there's
it
a
happened.
And then a snitch just told me that something happened.
Here's the thing, guys. Unless we can have proof that outside sources were used, I can't really deny them that. So, do we have proof? What are we claiming the extra ingredient was?
It's like some type of Haitian block. Basically, that's what it is. It's a Haitian seasoning block. Like, my grandmother used to use it, my mom. It's just like, it's very, very...
chicken stock. Powder or whatever.
It's cool. It's like a cool little product. It makes any dish taste good, bro. And they have it.
One more time.
Yeah, so guys, from our feedback, it wasn't just overall taste we need. We need cleanliness, we need steps of service, we need everything. Because when it comes to the kitchen, that's what it all is about. So what I have is, we do require full steps of service, cleanliness stations, everything, paying attention, all that. So I do believe the best overall dish today does belong to Jordan and Robin.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
We'll start working with you guys soon.
Take it back. We got it.
Back pocket. Take it out.
What are you talking about?
Take it out. No, he didn't take it out.
Back pocket.
Take it out. Open your hands. Open your hands. Open your hands. Look. He's just putting in his pants. All right, guys, just want to say congratulations to our two newest additions to the team. Well
Thank
done.
You, sir.
Well Great done. Cooking today.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate you guys coming out, all the competitors as well. Got a busy season coming up, so we hope they can bring what they offered today to the table.
All right, guys. They doubted us, man. They doubted us. I'm trying to tell you. They doubted us.
24 karat.
They didn't want to believe him.
A little heavy on the neck.
But hey, don't like. Don't comment. Where Robinson at? Stop over here, fam.
Don't.
Yes, so, don't subscribe.
Don't subscribe.
And we're out. Heaven must have sent you from the stars above.
Hey, bro, that food good?
Yo, yeah, it's good. So someone could choke on that. I got you, bro.
Britic German, man.
No way for you. Ain't no way for you to make this.
German crazy.
Did you try it?
It's hard, bro.
Blow it, bro. I'm
trying. You see the smoke coming out of this?
Blow it. Yeah.
Chef right here.
I'm trying to get inspiration, though.
You should have been racist.
No, I was.
No, man.
What do you mean? You don't get points off for this.
Interesting.
I love
him,
bro. I love
him. I hope we get this dub. It's gonna keep because of me. You know what I'm saying? Dooney, I don't see him in the kitchen, bro. I don't see him sauteing nothing, bro. You know me, I'm a beast with that l'espatula. But I don't know. I hope we get that dub. I love him, but he a little grits.